Welcome back to this component of the course where you're going to be getting the experience of working with both bind mounts and named volumes. Now, in preparation for this, make sure that you have watched the theory lesson on storage for Docker containers, and additionally, make sure that you've done the demo lesson on environment variables, which was earlier in the course, and make sure you understand all of the components within that demo section of the course. Now, as a prep step for this, we're going to run this command, and once again, this is just going to spin up our PHP myadmin admin container, which will allow us, if needed, to interact with the MariaDB database container. So go ahead and run that command, and that will just spin up a PHP myadmin container. Now, just to reiterate that all of the commands that we'll be using within this demo component of the course are contained in the text instructions attached to this video. So I'm going to clear the screen to make it easy to see. The instructions are actually split into two different components. So we have bind mounts and we have named volumes. In each of those components, there are specific steps that you need to perform, whether you're using Windows or macOS or Linux. Now, if you're using Windows, then the bind mount section might cause you more problems than if you're running Linux or macOS. So potentially you can do the bind mounts activities if you are running Windows, or you can just watch me do it. When we get onto the named volume part, then whether you're using Windows, macOS or Linux, you'll be able to follow those instructions. Now, we're going to start with bind mounts. Following on from the theory component of this course where I talked about Docker storage, bind mounts allow you to map a file or directory on the Docker host into a container. Now, this has pros and cons, but it can be useful if you need to access any files within a certain part of the container from the Docker host, or access a shared collection of files between containers or between containers and other compute services. So in this example, we're going to create a bind mount for the MariaDB data folder within the container and map it to a folder on our Docker host. Now, this can be done with two different command line options, hyphen V or double hyphen mount. And you'll see in the text instructions, I've included the command lines for both, but you only need to use one of them. You won't be able to use both because it will error. Now, I'm going to step you through how to use both of them. And first, what I want you to do is to move into your home folder. So on my machine, I can do that by typing CD and press enter. And then I'm going to go ahead and create a folder within my home folder. I'm going to use mkdir and then a space, and it's going to be called MariaDB underscore data. And then I'm going to move into that folder and do a listing and just show you that it's currently empty, so it contains no data. So then I'm going to move back up a level into my home folder and clear the screen. Now, the way that you use bind mounts within a Docker run command is by using this format. So we have Docker run, and don't worry about these backslashes, this just allows us to continue on a new line. And again, these are the instructions for macOS or Linux. If you're using Windows, it will be slightly different, and those differences are contained within the instructions attached to this video. But for macOS or Linux, we run a Docker run and then a backslash to continue on to the next line, double hyphen name DB. Then you specify the environment variables that you will have experienced in the previous demo component of the course. And then we have this extra command line option, which is double hyphen mount and then a space, type equals bind, and that tells Docker that we're using a bind mount. And then we need to specify the source of the bind mount, and this is a folder on the Docker host. Now, on macOS or Linux, dollar open brackets pwd close brackets evaluates to the current working directory, and then forward slash MariaDB underscore data is the folder that we created. So this represents my home folder forward slash MariaDB underscore data. So this is the folder on the Docker host. And then we're going to map this into the container in this path. So slash var slash lib slash MySQL. And this folder, remember, is the data folder for MariaDB. So let's go ahead and press enter. And that's going to run a container, but configure this bind mount. Now, to demonstrate that's worked, I'm going to go into the MariaDB underscore data folder and do a listing. And now you can see that this contains all of the files within the MariaDB data folder. Remember, that's this folder inside the container. So now this container folder is mapped into this folder on the Docker host. Any changes to this folder in the container will be reflected within this folder on the Docker host, and any changes in this folder on the Docker host will be reflected in this folder on the container. Now, if I go ahead and run a Docker stop DB, and then a Docker space RM DB to delete that container. This isn't in the instructions, I'm just doing this to illustrate the other format for configuring bind mounts. And then we have this command. So this is the variation of the command. Instead of using double hyphen mount, we use hyphen V. So hyphen V is a slightly different format. This just contains one big long string. It uses this to evaluate to our current working directory again, and then it specifies /MariaDB underscore data, and then it simply has a colon, and then it has the folder within the container. So this is a shorter way than using double hyphen mount. Both are valid, both do exactly the same thing. So if I press enter, the process is the same, the container will be created, and it will be using a bind mount. Now let's just go ahead and tidy this up. So again, Docker space stop space DB, and then Docker space RM space DB. And then I'll clear the screen, move back up one level to my home folder, and then I need to delete this MariaDB underscore data folder on the Docker host. The way that you do this on macOS or Linux is to run an RM space hyphen RF space, and then the name of the folder and press enter. And that will delete it. And then I'll clear the screen. Now next I want to talk about volumes, specifically named volumes. So volumes are the preferred way of adding storage to Docker containers outside of the lifecycle of a container. They're managed entirely by Docker, and they work whether you're using Windows container hosts or Linux container hosts. Now instead of mapping a container folder to a folder on the Docker host, you essentially create a volume or have Docker do this on your behalf. And this is entirely managed end-to-end by Docker. And this volume exists outside of the lifecycle of a container. So if you delete a container, this volume continues to exist. Now, in terms of creating a volume, we would use this command. So Docker space volume space create, and then the name of the volume that we want to create. So if we go ahead and run this command, it's going to create a volume called MariaDB underscore data. And we can see all of the volumes that we have available by running a Docker space volume space ls and press enter. And there we can see at the bottom, we've got the named volume that I just created. You can review the metadata of a volume by running a Docker space volume and then inspect and then the name of this volume. So in our case, MariaDB underscore data. And we can see here all of the information about this volume. So when it was created, its name and other metadata. We can delete a volume by running a Docker space volume space RM and then again the name of that volume and press enter. And now that volume is deleted, and if we run a Docker space volume space ls, we'll see that volume has gone. So I'm going to clear the screen. Volumes get created either explicitly when you run a Docker volume create command, or alternatively, if you specify to use a volume on the Docker run command and one doesn't already exist, then it gets created as part of that process. Now again, we can use the double hyphen mount way of defining this, or we can use the hyphen V way. I've included both in the text instructions for this component of the course, and again, you should choose to use one. For this video, I'm going to use the double hyphen mount method. So I'm just going to paste that command in. So you can see here we've got double hyphen mount and then source equals MariaDB underscore data. And this creates a named volume with this name. And then we have target, and we're specifying the folder within the container that this volume will be mapped to. And if we go ahead and run this command, it's going to run the container. And if we do a Docker space volume space ls, we can see that as part of this command, it's created this volume. Now, I mentioned how volumes exist outside the lifecycle of a container. Let me show you what I mean. I'm going to clear the screen to make it easy to see, and then I'm going to run a docker space stop space db, and that will stop the database container. Then I'm going to run a listing of all the volumes that we have, and notice how the MariaDB underscore data volume still exists. And then I'm going to run a docker space rm space db to fully delete the database container. And then again, I'll run a docker space volume space ls, and notice how this named volume still exists. So let's just clear the screen. If I run the docker run command again, note how though this time I'm using the hyphen v notation. With this format, you just specify the name of the named volume to create, and then a colon, and then the folder that you want to map this to inside the container. Now note how that we already have a volume with this name, so if I use the docker run command with the name of an existing volume and press enter, it doesn't create a new volume, it just reuses the existing one. So if I run a docker space volume space ls, we're reusing this existing docker volume, we're not creating a new one. So this is a way that you can maintain data that persists after you delete a container, and this is really useful for high availability or if you want to do software updates of containers. If we open our web browser and go to http://localhost:8081, it will load in our PHP myadmin. If we go back to the terminal, run a docker space ps, just get the container ID of the MariaDB container, run a docker space inspect and then paste this container ID, just get the internal IP address of the MariaDB container, go back to the web browser, paste that into the server box, root for the username and some WordPress for the password, and then click on login, we can log in just fine to this MariaDB container, even though we deleted it and recreated it. It's using the same data and that's stored within that named volume. Now the behavior of this specific container, so the MariaDB container image, is that if you have a named volume, and if that's got valid data on, then it will reuse that data. So that means reuse any of the databases which have been created and reuse any of the user accounts. So the second time that we used that docker run command and reused the existing volume, it didn't recreate any of the users or the databases, it used that existing data. And that's going to form a core part of how you can achieve long-running applications using Docker containers by using persistent data using named volumes or bind mounts. Now at this point, that's everything I wanted to cover in this demo component of the course. All that remains is to do some cleanup. So go back to the terminal and clear the screen to make it easier to see. Then run a docker space stop space db. That will stop the MariaDB container. Then a docker space rm space db to delete that container. We need to do the same for phpMyAdmin. So docker space stop space phpMyAdmin. And then docker space rm space, and again phpMyAdmin. And that will delete that container. And then if we do a docker space volume space ls, we can go ahead and delete this volume, because as I mentioned earlier, this will persist beyond the life cycle of that container. So we need to delete it manually. So docker space volume space rm space, and then the name of the volume and press enter. And that's deleted that named volume. Now at this point, that's everything I wanted to cover in this demo component of the course. You've learned about bind mounts, so you can map folders within a container to folders on the Docker host, and you've learned about named volumes, which are storage managed by Docker, which can persist past the lifetime of any single container. We're going to be extending on this in the next demo component of the course, where you're going to be looking at Docker Compose, and Docker Compose is a way of managing multi-container applications. For now though, when you're ready, you can go ahead and move on to the next part of the course.